Yo, Joe, Nguyen, you won this J. Scott Campbell variant from last week's giveaway. Thank you so much for liking, subscribing, and commenting. Comic fam, this video is made possible because of the best comic book app that exists on the market, Key Collector Comics. Support the show, get access to all this information we're talking about. You would have gotten it days ago if you use the app for Androids and iPhones and use code TOM101 to unlock a free subscription. Enjoy your video. Another week, another list of the hottest comic books that may define a generation of comic book collectors. At the table, like I do every single week, hit the subscribe button with Gem from Gem Mint Collectibles.
What's up, Tom? What's up to the comic book fam? Feels good to be back. Can't wait to jump into the list.
Yo, we got a packed one. We have a lot of new comic books to discuss, a lot of movement in the market, and we should start it out at number 10 because I think over this last couple weeks, Gem, we've started to see a little bit of a change to the market. More collectors starting to focus on blue chip comic books. Can you remind the community what that means?
A blue chip comic book is like a safe bet. It's like a book that always goes up in value and is traditionally for classic characters. First appearance of Spider-Man, Iron Man, Hulk, Wolverine, X-Men, those type of characters.
So we do have those books on this list. But where did we come from? Where did this begin? Because it started with a push towards variant comic books, modern books, books that are second, third, cover Bs, and newsstands. So at the list at number 10, we have Outlawed issue number 1. And this comic book features multiple characters, really the trio of characters that have come up on this show multiple times in the last 3 months. And we're talking about Kamala, we're talking about Miles Morales, and we're talking about Riri Williams. This is a 1 in 50 variant that is done by Anna Rudd. Covers are fantastic. However, this book came out in mid-March, just prior to the full-scale lockdown and shutdown of Diamond distributions for multiple months. Now that collectors are looking for these different variants to speculate on, they're looking for these low print numbered comic books, they're now hunting for what could be the most scarce book to come out of pandemic. We know high ratio sales are the focus of the most affluent collectors right now, and that's why we're seeing a $450 sale for this comic book. Will it still be on the list next week? I'm not sure, but clearly collectors are looking for comic books to speculate on prior to that full shutdown happening.
Wow, so not even a first appearance or anything. It's just a very low ratio variant. It was hard to get, and just has some of these next generation characters on the cover.
That's right. People trying to scoop them up before they are gone completely. What do we got at number 9?
Number 9 is a book that I like. I think this is a good pick. This is Thor, God of Thunder, issue 2. We're talking about the newsstand variant. This is the Jason Aaron run where he first introduces Gore, the God Butcher. Also, it's the first appearance of the Necro Sword, which is the first symbiote created by Null.
We've been chatting about Null for months nonstop, but you got to remind the community about the importance of that barcode.
Yeah, the newsstand editions differ from the direct market versions that only go to comic shops because those newsstand editions were returnable so that retailers could get rid of them and get their money back if they didn't sell. So there's less of them out there. The last publicly sold raw copy before this current sale was $230. The last sale for this book, a raw copy, sold for $600. So a huge jump from that last sale.
The estimate count of these newsstands ranges between a low 1 and 3% of the total copies printed. Gem, you gotta discuss the discovered copies, the copies that we currently know of.
Experts have tracked that there are only approximately 40 copies of this newsstand edition in existence, and there's only 2 known graded copies. We have one that's graded at a 9.4 and another at an 8.0.
Oh my goodness, comic fam, you got to be checking that barcode. Some of you may have this book, and 9.4 is the highest graded copy on the census. But you know what? If we're talking about Thor 2, Gem, we got to hit him with Thor 6.
Yeah, Thor issue 6 is the first cameo appearance of Null. That and a newsstand is incredibly rare to find, especially in high grade. So you guys got to dig through those boxes to see if you're holding on to one.
Before we get to number 8, I want to make sure the comic fam knows that if they comment down below, it'll enter them to win a giveaway. We do these all the time on the show. And this one right here is It Eats What Feeds It, the Ben Templesmith Virgin variant. And let's chat about number 8 on the list, because post-DC fandom, we saw so many books spike. And I would like to welcome a comic book from the trending list. We have Superboy, issue number 9, the first appearance of King Shark. Post-DC fandom, this book lit up. And just how much did it go up? Well, we were just chatting about this book earlier in the year. It was going for $50 strong in near mint, and we knew that this character was going to be in Suicide Squad. Well, after DC fandom, heck, after the trailer, as well as the video game announcement, this character is going to be in both franchises, and this book has moved up. 9.8 is hitting $160, and that is a major change when this book was selling on average for $50 just a year ago. And I want to remind everybody that this is one of the few DC keys that actually has a different edition available to the public. A different variant. And you may be thinking, wait a minute, DC wasn't doing variants back then. No, this was a DC Universal logo variant. Jem, fill them in.
Yeah, these were only available in the DC Comics multi-packs that were available at Toys R Us. They would come with a number of different comics, and they had these different logos in the barcode, making it a much more rare version of this book.
Here's the thing, man. This is something that collectors are just starting to figure out now. This is like Mark Jewelers 3 years ago. And we saw a 9.8 DC Universal logo variant of this very comic book sell for under $140 earlier last month. Comic fam, you got to know your DC logo variants, and you got to know what to be watching out for, because that book came and went quick and you could have gotten it.
All right, number 7 on this list is a book that does not include any first appearances. It is not a variant. It's not even a low print run book, but it's on the list nevertheless as Batman 423. This is just a classic cover by Todd McFarlane. Let's look into these sales. Last week, this book sold for $850 and a 9.8. Earlier in the week, it sold for $910. Now we have a sale that has just crossed the $1,000 mark and sold for $1,051.
Whoa, those are some big numbers. But you know what? If they don't believe us, we got to hit them with the McFarlane yellow label that sold this week as well.
That book sold for $1,800 on eBay. And really, everything McFarlane is heating up. I don't know if it's because of his successful Kickstarter, or if it's because there are Spawn movie rumors, or if it's because his Amazing Spider-Man 317 page, one single page, sold for $58,544. All I know is there are other big McFarlane books out there that we need to keep an eye on. I'm thinking stuff like Hulk 340.
That's right. We are seeing those classic covers by the legend start to become coveted keys that may be defining a generation of collectors right here, right now. Let's take a look at number 6, because we had a major loss over this last week. Sometimes these comic books lists and discussions, it's about speculation. And I liked what Russ, the comic sensei, said on the trending list this week. He said other times it's about respect. And this right here is one of those moments.
Yeah, so unexpected to hear about the loss of Chadwick Boseman. He was such an important character to so many people out there. But most importantly, I mean, he was a person who had a family. He was part of a family, and just so sad to see someone go at such a young age. And like I said, who meant so much to everybody.
He was a young 43, and it happened so suddenly. And he did so much over the course of these 4 years that it's amazing what he was going through at the same time. He was teaming up with Marvel Studios, helping sick children, doing charity work, and, you know, happened to be part of one of the most culturally important films of our generation.
I'm hearing a lot of fans out there saying that Marvel should not recast T'Challa and that they should let his sister Shuri take the mantle of Black Panther in the MCU like she did in the comics, which is a very clear indication on why this book is spiking.
Ooh, I love this here. We're talking about Black Panther issue number 2. This is the first appearance of Shuri in comic books, and I think this is a major moment in the collecting community right now, because this is them speaking. This is the community at large saying that Chadwick did his job. He personified the role. He became our Black Panther. Pass the mantle down.
Yeah, collectors are speaking by pushing this book to a $750 average and a 9.8. So very strong sales on this first appearance. Her first appearance as Black Panther is in Black Panther 5 from the 2009 volume, which is a book to keep an eye on as well.
Moving over at the list in number five, we have a comic book that is moving so quickly up in price that we actually have to tell you not to buy it for double the amount it's selling for, because that's what it's being listed for. All right, we got Young Avengers issue number one, the Wizard World VIP CGC 9.5 edition. Remind the community, Jim, what's going on with the 9.5 issue of this comic book, because that's not on the grading scale.
This was part of the Wizard First program. It was a collaboration with CGC where they had these red label 9.5s. This one was even numbered to only 285.
That's right. This book is a ghost. And we knew with the rise of speculators looking at the next generation heroes that Young Avengers 1 is an easy one to spec on. But which version? Because there's a bunch of them. Well, this one is already slabbed for you. It's already scarce and it's already hyper low print because they're actually numbered. And we have another $3,000 sale to report on this book with a couple of unverified $3,000 sales in the private market. Now, something that I want to highlight here is that when we say things like this, that we have information about sales that are happening in the private market, that's because we have Analysis X to thank for it. The writer of this list, he chooses to remain anonymous. But what I can tell you, comic fam, is that there are multiple individuals that are all coming together to help source us information on the comic book industry, providing us information that you can't even find in an Overstreet.
Yeah, this list takes a lot of people working together to make it happen.
The record of this comic book was made just a short couple weeks ago, hitting a $3,051 marker with multiple sales at the $3,000 mark. I think Young Avengers is here to stay.
All right, number four on the list is a book that has been on the list for the past few weeks now. We're talking about Amazing Fantasy 15, Volume 2, First Appearance of Amadeus Cho, a.k.a. Mastermind Excello, a.k.a. The Totally Awesome Hulk. This book has broken records in every single grade. Let's take a look at it. An 8.5 sold for $100 more than the previous record. It was selling for $65. It last sold for $165.88. A 9.0 went from $150 to $200. A 9.2 sold for $275, beating its previous record of $185. A 9.4 sold for $325, smashing the previous record of $230. A 9.6 just beat out its previous record, selling at $492, where the last sale was $475. And then we have the 9.8. We have the most recent sale at $1,100, beating its previous record of $1,009.
We just got done telling you about Young Avengers spec comic fam, and it's these characters, Riri, Kamala, Amadeus, Spider-Gwen, these next generation heroes. And I didn't even mention a bunch of the Young Avengers in that line because there's so many to speculate on. Clearly, Amadeus Cho is a fan favorite.
Yeah, people are scooping up these books fast. Number three on the list is not going to be as easy. We're talking about Giant Size X-Men number one, first appearance of the new X-Men team, one of the biggest Bronze Age books out there on the market. It is making extraordinary gains in low grades.
All right, we got to take a look at these numbers because my jaw is dropping, comic fam. We have five new records to report on right now. We have a 4.0 that was once going for $1,060, hitting an all-new record at $1,226. We have two 4.5 graded copies, both matching the all-time record at $1,350. All right, now we have a 6.0 to talk about. This is when the prices start really creeping up. Previously, this book at an all-time high was 1.7,000. New record reporting 6.0 hitting $1,920. A 6.5 moves it up even higher at $2,250. And now, last to report, an 8.5 setting an all-new record, a once $3,300 book hitting $3,400. And to top this whole thing off, this comic book has easily made it clear that white pagers, that paper quality, is really starting to matter because we are seeing the height of the market start to just have drastic differences depending on page quality, and that is not something that's traditional.
Yeah, that 9.8 white pager sold for $16,257. Now, to put it in perspective, in 2017, a 9.8 sold for a high of $6,500, and in 2018, the high was $10,000. So we're looking at $16,000 right now.
comic fan, this is what we were chatting about earlier on the show. We were alluding to this. Clearly, comic book collectors are focused back on those blue chip comic books. And I have a feeling it's because of shutdown. It's because of Diamond Distribution not distributing comics. Speculation started to move towards books based off of scarcity, based off of print counts and you know, printings. And now we are starting to see comic book focus revert back to the longer term spec. And we all know that X-Men is just inevitable.
Yeah, but also these modern books are starting to outprice collectors. You have modern 9.8 selling for over $1,000. You have 1 out of 25 variants selling for $8,000, newsstand editions selling for $9,000. So it's like at this point, I might as well be buying a Silver Age Key issue if I'm spending this much money.
I really appreciate you bringing that up, Jem, because when these books start to price themselves out, that right there is the height of the market. It's not going to go higher than that. So what happens? Well, if those sales don't keep up, we will typically see a drop. Not much. Typically, it's 10 to 20%. And then over time, depending on speculation and how the market moves, it goes back up for the most part. We are talking about the height of the market. But we are talking about characters like Miles Morales, who is clearly leading the charge. And this right here is the very first Hot 10 list where he is not at number one.
Yeah, man, this is the first time since we've been doing this top 10 list that Ultimate Fallout 4 is not number one. And I kind of like the book that knocked it out of its place, but we'll get to that. But yeah, Ultimate Fallout 4, number two on the list. Still good. Still one of the hottest books in the market right now. Let's talk about what it's doing.
We're talking about Ultimate Fallout issue number four at number two. The Bagley cover. The cover that was distributed in polybag because I believe this comic book has officially hit its height because comic books are starting to retreat in price. Let's take a look at the numbers. So we'll start them off with the high sales. 9.8s have dipped, but not much. I mean, this is a book that's selling very aggressively. Still number two on the list. $1,200 was their previous average, and we are here to report an average of $1,000 for a 9.8. Now, raws have really taken a hit. Remember, we were seeing that book push up above 400 bucks at one point. We thought it would probably hit around 500. It's back down to $350 raw. Now, the Dejavik variant, we're still seeing that book, you know, price at high levels. You know, we were reporting back last week that we were seeing $9,000 sales of that book. We're seeing a 9.6 of the Dejavik variant hit a staggering $4,500 this week. So right there, that's matching the all-time record. But we are starting to see a movement, and that's why we got to replace the number one on this list with a Copper Age goodie.
Yeah, man, we're talking about Turtle Power, baby. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles issue number one. We're talking about first prints, second prints, all around. This book is super hot, and let's look into what's going on. First of all, a CGC 8.5 sold for $15,500 back in August, which is up from the previous sale of $9,700. That book hit $16,177 this week, smashing that record. Followed by an 8.0 sale, which sold for $10,000. Now, what happens when we start pricing ourselves out of that first print? Collectors start going for the second print, and we have huge gains here as well. A CGC 3.0 for the second print used to sell for about $335. We have sales in the $1,300 range now. What's even crazier is we have raw sales for $4,000, which is smashing the all-time record for a 9.6. Somebody must have thought that thing looks super clean and has 9.8 potential. Guys, we're doing this video every week, so hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, hit the notification bell, drop us a comment below. Tom, what do you think about TMNT?
You know I love me some TMNT, Jem. I got Shredder and the Turtles tattooed on me for a reason, and I was freaking out when I saw the printer's proof sell at the Comics Link auction just over this last couple weeks. After 77 bids, we saw what was honestly something that was a myth, something that people didn't even think was real. But Kevin Eastman, the co-creator, authenticated this printer's proof copy, saying that this is actually the first time that they were in a position where they had to review the comic book and they were given a copy prior to it hitting the printer to okay it, to say, yes, print us our 3,000 plus copies of this issue. And that book went for $12,000. $472.
That's almost like one of those Stan Lee file copies.
What an amazing piece of comic book memorabilia. Comic fam, what'd you think of this list? What'd you think about these books? Do you have any in your collection? We want to hear from you. And then, as always,
geek responsibly and stay minty fresh.
Enough said. Comic fam, we got two different videos for you to check out. This one up here is featuring Very Gary from Very Gary Comics. It's so dope. We chat about Donny Cates' Thor with Fire Guy Ryan. And then, of course, we have The Overstreet, Price Guide, Advisor, Russ Bright, chatting the trending books of the week right there. Have a great rest of your week, Comic fam.